Here in Costa Rica, we have some stores called outlets that import items from the US, mainly from retailers like Amazon and Best Buy. You can get products at quite a reasonable price, so during a visit to one of these outlets, I discovered a Lenovo PC for around $50. I believe there's always a good use for an old PC, so I just went for it. I turned the PC on when I arrived home and noticed that it came with Windows 8, so I just replaced the hard drive with an SSD and then installed Ubuntu server. Even though I'm a long-time Apple user, mainly because of my creative work, I've also been a huge fan of Linux for its flexibility, which is something that I have appreciated for many years. Not gonna lie, I've been looking for a Raspberry Pi or an old PC for quite some time to start a home server project, so this PC felt like it was the perfect opportunity for me to just go for it. After installing Linux, I quickly set up Docker and installed several tools: Jellyfin, Transmission, Pi-hole, Homebridge, and FreshRSS. All of them are open source and available for anyone. So I did the process using Docker, and as someone without previous knowledge about it, everything was super easy to set up, and everything also worked pretty much right away. So I made this video to highlight the three main open source tools that I have been using for this home server project. The first up is FreshRSS. I used to rely on Twitter, well now called X, for news updates, with it essentially replacing my use of RSS around 2010, but since I have stopped using Twitter, I wanted a simple free tool to stay updated with my favorite websites. FreshRSS allows me to view updates chronologically without any algorithms getting in the way. It runs locally on my server, and the best part is that I'm in complete control. I know that there are other Twitter alternatives like Threads, Mastodon, Blue Sky, and a few more, but I wanted to keep things as simple as possible, and FreshRSS has provided just what I needed. Some people might find the user interface not very attractive, but as with any other open source tools, you have the possibility to customize it to your needs, and it also allows the possibility to achieve that by using additional extensions. Another favorite has been Homebridge. I often find inexpensive smart bulbs at these outlets, and given that I'm in the Apple ecosystem, I'm generally limited to pricier HomeKit devices. I didn't really expect much from Homebridge, since I know that compatibility with Apple devices can be tricky sometimes, but it has been surprisingly reliable. For about 6 months, I have connected all my smart devices locally without a hitch. Occasionally, there is a slight delay with a light bulb, but it's no more than 10 seconds. I currently use Homebridge with Local Tuya, which has been seamless. And despite the fact that I'm using Local Tuya, I can manage all my devices remotely. Of course, not with HomeKit, but I do it through the Homebridge user interface using Tailscale. Lastly, there's Pi-hole. Using Pi-hole has significantly improved my browsing experience. I can block ads across all devices in my network and even later data-hungry devices, especially certain smart TVs that I have noticed love to keep sending data to servers all over the world. The best part is that I can block ads everywhere by connecting to my home server via a personal VPN using Tailscale, even when I am not at home, either using my mobile data plan or another Wi-Fi network. Now that I have mentioned Tailscale, it pretty much is a VPN that allows me to access my home server from anywhere, as if I were home, providing me all the same benefits, including ad blocking and access to my media without any extra fees or monthly charges. In my case, I don't intend to use it for geo-blocking, but you can set up exit nodes and access contents from other countries if you need it. So if you're traveling to another country and you also want access to contents from where you live, let's say the UK or the US, and if those contents are geo-blocked, you can easily set up an exit node and access everything as if you were there. All the traffic will go through an encrypted WireGuard connection. Tailscale is a very simple, easy way to set up your personal VPN using WireGuard. I am aware that some people might not like the idea of relying on a third party for this type of connection and would rather prefer to install WireGuard directly. In my case, I didn't mainly for a matter of convenience, but I believe there's a good learning opportunity there, and it's actually something that I'm doing on another machine. When it comes to Linux, I have discovered that almost every issue that I have encountered so far is very well documented online, making problem solving relatively straightforward. By the way, I built this dashboard with the help of GPT-4 and it is currently self-hosted using NGINX. I have integrated my most used software and even added an exchange rate for Costa Rican currency, US dollar display for quick access. I would love to hear your experiences with self-hosting, so drop your tips and advice in the comment section below for me and anyone else venturing into this realm. Thanks for watching and I hope you enjoyed this video. We'll be right back.